Hey everybody, this is Egg400 bringing you the next episode of Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. In this episode, we're going to continue the plot. I was originally going to go do side quest things to level up, but then I learned that there were level 5 Chijoe over here because I'm a scrub lord. So I didn't actually have to go around the world and level in 80 days. So next side quest episode being delayed just the tiniest bit more. That's really, really cool. Moving on. Ah, you must be the adventurer standing in for our injured companions. Terribly unfortunate business, that. Yeah, here are the Chicoe egg sacs. It seems, however, that you had little trouble gathering the egg sacs in their stead. Excellent work. I shall have them sent over to the Trappers League immediately. Lest you wonder, these eggs are not destined for the dinner table. Members of the Twin Adder and the Wood Whalers are assisting the League by collecting the samples they need to check for signs of sickness. The Chigoe, you see, is one of the few creatures capable of transmitting the disease known as the Creeping Death. Until relatively recently, any Hyork who contracted this disease would almost invariably perish. Indeed, a single outbreak once claimed the lives of a third of the Huron population here in Gridania. That was a long time ago, of course. With the medicines available to us now, the Creeping Death is not the killer it once was. Even so, it is best to halt any new outbreaks before they occur. Thus, we gather Chigoe eggs on a regular basis in order to assist the Trappers League with their ongoing research. Your timely assistance is most appreciated. Thanks, sir. Did it. Surveying the damage. A guard at Gilbert's Spire named Moranguin needs you to recover the surveying equipment left behind in a cave by a startled recruit. Such an embarrassing turn of events. I sent a recruit from the Bannock on a surveying expedition, only for the Craven to turn tail and flee at the first sign of trouble. This is not how we treat requests from the Conjurers. And if such a poor showing weren't bad enough, the lily-livered halfwit left behind the surveying equipment provided by the hearer Pauline herself. While I attempt to instill some backbone into this so-called soldier, would you mind recovering the survey gear and returning it to hearer Pauline at Gabino's bower? According to my recruit's tale of woe, there should be a set of survey records, a surveyor's rope, and two boxes of surveyor's instruments strewn about the interior of the cave to the south of here. It's a wonder the damn fool didn't lose his boots. Matron, watch over you. This guy sounds like my level of talent. That's not a good thing. Okay. If I recall right, the cave in particular was this watery cave over here. I don't know why there's a level 9 water sprite here. So as you can see, there's a whole bunch of creatures here that I could kill for my hunting log, so before we progress, there's no reason not to, you know, get some work done, right? And that's both the Black Aft and Water Sprite done, for those of you needing to know a good place to grind them for yours. I know that I think maybe that Conjurers have to deal with Bog Yarzons. I'm not entirely sure. But don't be afraid to fight them. That's a bunch of croc. As you can see, this cave is actually pretty full of enemies that are willing to aggro on sight. So be prepared, take your time, do not rush. I can't stress that enough. You do not want to get more than one of these things on your tail. It is not fun fighting more than one at once, especially if you're the same level. Believe me when I say it's just a better idea to deal with them than to just run through and try and grab things, because if they attack you, they'll interrupt your interactions, which makes it doubly hard, as you're about to see. Because this guy is frickin' rude! Get another Yarzon to add to the kill list. Okay, presuming that that last one doesn't turn around and attack my spinal cord, that should be everything. I will meet you guys back at the place. Also, now that we don't actually have an objective to do, I'm more than willing to run past these slow things. Welcome to Green Tier. Apparently, this is where the surveying equipment has to go, so here it goes. What am I looking for? Oh, you. Hello, Pauline. Yes, may I assist you with some manner? Oh, but this is the equipment I left with the soldiers of the Bannock. For the first sign of danger, you see. You say. I see. Well, all is not lost. It appears the recruit managed to complete the surveying assignment. The records are actually quite detailed. With the changes wrought by the calamity, I thought it wise to send the Order of the Twin Adder on a number of expeditions to the maps. The region's topography. As Borgin would have it, the officers saw these tasks as an excellent opportunity to train and experience soldiers. We can no longer rely on our past knowledge with 12's wood if we are to survive these troubled times. We must reacquaint ourselves with our surroundings, so that we may better discern the threats we face. Stay vigilant, adventurer. I get new pants. You want pants. Pants are good. Leveling up is also good. Just... ooh, heavier shot. Nice. I still look stupid. You have my story quest. Where do I go next? If you might spare the time, Zayaku, I would have you thin the numbers of the hoglets in Green Tier. While these beasts have always called the 12 wood home, their appetite has grown so insatiable of late that I fear they will devour every nut on the floor. The cycle of life cannot well sustain such gluttony. I must ask you to slay at least 6 of the creatures. The sacrifice will be to the greater good of the 12's wood, I assure you. Sure thing, bruh. I like killing things. And if they're bad pigs, maybe I'll get some bacon. Oh, well, that was effective. So as you might be suspect to think, the pigs aren't that actually difficult. So, I'm guessing, while I'm just sitting here carving away at this poor last pig, that I should go over something real quick. Every single area, as you've probably been able to guess, has different starting missions. These missions tend to teach you how to play the game, most of the basics, but they also do them each in different ways. I don't know about Nimza Lominza, but I do know that in Olda, I do not recall a point where you're required to get 5th level gear. Wait, nope, never mind, I just remembered. It was in the, I can't remember the name of the outpost, but I believe it was... And we're back, one cat attack later, with several new holes in my legs. Yes, the elements rejoice at your actions. The life of the forest lies on a delicate balance, and the unchecked proliferation of beasts would mean a slow but certain death for the 12's wood. It is our duty to correct such imbalance and swiftly, even if it means shedding blood. Though it may seem trivial, you have performed a vital service this day. May the elementals bless your future endeavors. You get a ring! Just joking, they're wristbands, but they're still good. Better than what you got from the store, anyway. And they don't look as silly, either. Look at me being so serious. You have my next story quest, too? Oh! You get a ring! Yeah. Tell me what you need. A word with you, Zag. I hesitate to make such a dangerous request, but might you assist us in thinning the number of Anoles on Naked Rock? In our effort to commune with the Elementals, we conjurers often find ourselves in that area. Of late, however, our meditations have all too frequently been interrupted by unprovoked Anole attacks. Truly, the beasts grow more aggressive by the day. The numbers have continued to grow since the advent of the 7th Emerald Era, you see, forcing packs of the Scale Skin to come down from the mountain in search of food. If you could slay a half dozen or so of the beasts, that should lessen their need to hunt, and also serve as a warning to Anoles to remain within their territory. But I am afraid you must do more than thin the existing population. If we are to truly break the spiraling growth, then we must also target their future offspring. Bring me 4 Anole eggs and you will have played your part in returning balance to this area of the forest. Yep. We're killing babies. Don't get mad at me. It's what the game's telling me to do. And it's not a bad thing, it's for the balance of nature. For all the weirdness that it is. So, these are Anole. They're annoying. They're everywhere. They make your life harder. Needless to say, I'm not a fan of them. I don't know many who are. I will more than happily kill these. It's the eggs that make me feel bad. But apparently, they can breathe ice breath. I'm not sure if they're related to dragons. Oh, and that's the other thing, as you just saw when it died, removing its quest symbol, these are actually part of the Archer Hunter log, so keep that in mind if you're the same as me. Get wrecked. We have to slay 6 Anoles. I only need 4 for my log. And then after that, we have to crush eggs. Does it make me feel a little bad? Well, yeah. Being a murderer of creatures that haven't even had a chance to live yet really sucks. But to progress in this game, it is sadly the necessary. So, kill I must. I will see you once I get to the eggs. That's the hunter's log, and that's an egg. Okay, so aside from that level up, that thing dropped to me something very useful. High-quality Anole skins. There's a chance when you defeated an enemy that they will drop materials that you can use for crafting. At the same time, they have a chance of dropping a higher quality version. Not every crafting material comes in high quality, but high-quality materials increase the chances of high-quality crafting, something we'll get into later. So, remember that. So it's time for me to go home. And break my legs. Breaking your legs is very important. Ow. I'm back. With the eggs. Ah, you have returned. Now might my brothers and sisters continue their meditations undisturbed. You have my thanks. As for these eggs, may I ask you to deliver them to Tsubkazam... Kamazam at the Bannock. Anole eggs are both large and filled with nutrition. The perfect meal for a soldier. She will be more than a little pleased to see you, I should imagine. Cool beans. I'll do that. So, on the way there, there is actually something I'd like to talk about. Earlier I mentioned that every area has a start, which teaches you the basics of the game, and basically has a clone quest in every area, similar, well, you know, you have to get these clothes, you have to kill this amount of things. They're properly flavored and everything, but in the end, they're technically all the same in terms of mechanics. What's different is that, well, nothing, really, their flavor, which I personally enjoy, but regardless. Something to keep in mind, though, these tend to take place from levels 1 to 15, I believe? I'm level 9 right now, which means that I'm about two-thirds through on these quests. Afterwards, you're going to enter what can be considered the common plot, where all of the plots converge and continue from what you could consider to be... Thank you. What you can consider to be the main quest line for the rest of the game. So, just know that it's going to not be around the whole time, and that it'll end soon. Now, back to our main plot. An eft for the effort. An eft for effort? Okay, that's cute. I didn't realize that was a pun. Gelfried, chief instructor of the Bannock, wishes you to assist with the training of new recruits. Zek, thank you for your assistance with the Shigoe operation. Might you be willing to aid me in another manner? Allow me to explain. The nearby river is home to a colony of black efts, whom I sent a party of recruits to slay. Yet scarcely a bell after I had done so, the youngsters returned, hysterical yet noticeably unbloodied, and loudly bemoaned their misfortune at ever having been sent to contend with such hell-born horrors. Pitiful. My great-grandma could dispatch an eft with her walking stick and a harsh word. That such a task could cow a whole party of able-bodied men and women is beyond belief. I would have you show these quivering milksops how it's done. Make your way to the river and put down 4 of the creatures. Oh, sure. So around level 15 is when you're going to be leaving your starting area and beginning what could be called the main quest that everyone participates in. Now, something to keep in mind. That is also when you unlock the ability to get other classes. I made the decision very early on, before this series actually started recording, that I was actually going to be a black mage. Yet, as you can tell, I'm an archer right now. Not a thaumaturge, which is the base class for black mage. This is a choice I made with the idea in mind that I'm going to switch to thaumaturge upon reaching Uldah. The reason for this is very simple. Every single job has a primary class. For black mage, it's thaumaturge, but they also have a secondary class. This secondary class has to at least be level 15 before it can count as being high enough for you to be able to get the consequential job of the main class. For example, black mage requires 15 levels in archer as well as 30 levels in thaumaturge to unlock. If I didn't go and start with archer, then when I finished the starting area, I would have been sent here, and I would have to pick up archer, stop what I'm doing, grind it up to 15, or skip it, and just keep playing thaumaturge until I got to level 30, and then suddenly have to stop and do a boring, obnoxious grind. What I personally recommend you do, if you're like me and don't want to waste any time, I would recommend starting as your secondary class. So that way you can use the first main plot quest to plow through your secondary class very quickly. And then you can switch to your primary, and you'll sadly have to grind it up to the point where you can actually do main plot again, but you will never have to leave the class. You will always stay in your class no matter what. You won't have to stop at level 30 when all the exciting stuff's happening to become an archer and grind through what can be considered really, really cruddy fates and whatnot. I'll cover fate grinding later. To actually be able to get the job you want. I don't like that idea. The end of this area leaves a perfect note for you to just pause and change classes. So that way you don't feel as if you're ripping yourself from a very exciting story just yet. This is just my personal preference, but it's what I recommend. If you're more keen to just plow through the plot, do as you wish. Just remember, every single job has a subclass that's required. I'll put those on screen now. So, remember that. Welcome back, Zack. You performed admirably. I had my recruits watching from the bank as you dispatched the Eft. It appears your skill in battle has inspired them. Either that, or they have no wish to be upstaged by an adventure, which matters little. What does matter is that they have resumed their training with renewed zeal, and that I have you to thank for it. I am in your debt. Hey man, not a problem though. Give me that maple longbow. Yeah. So, before they had you go and shop out equipment, but from now on, they're going to keep you regularly stocked on equipment through main quests, and if you try them, side quests as well. The only time that you're really going to get equipment that's above the norm is when you get to dungeons. And that equipment will tend to last you up until near the next dungeon. So, just something to keep in mind. Zazayaku, thank the gods you've come. I literally just stopped talking to you. We have a potential crisis on our hands, and I would appreciate your assistance. Will you hear me out? That's a rock man. I mean, I'll help, but that's a rock man. Listen well, for we haven't much time. To the southeast of here lies a dungeon known as Spirit Hold. It was all but destroyed during the calamity. Desiring to offer the ruins back to the forest, a hero ventured inside to carry out the rite of returning. Alas, it would seem something has gone awry. Word arrived just moments ago that the hero and his guard have been attacked by a towering shadow. Aye, you heard me true. A shadow. On any other day, I would dispatch my best quivermen to provide support. But I sent them to repel an Ixil incursion in the West Shroud nearly a bell ago. The timing of these events cannot be a mere coincidence. I fear the Ixil somehow caught wind of our plans and are attempting to disrupt the rite in an effort to weaken the bond between the man and the elementals. They must not be allowed to succeed, so I bid you to go to Spirit Hold and do whatever is necessary to resolve the situation. Please, say you will help us. I have no choice. I knew you wouldn't let me down. You will have all the support I can muster. Now, we are racing against time, so you'd best make haste. You know, you could go yourself. It's not that far, and all you do is stand there. I mean, you are a quest giver. Standing there is your job. But whatever. Just don't leave it to the government or your own military or anything. Just leave it to the foreigners from some other country to deal with your problems. You know, because that worked well. You know, with the dragon. Who goes there? An adventurer, is it? Here at Instructor Galfeed's request, you say. Thank the matron. Doubtless you already know this, but a towering shadow manifested without warning and attacked the hero in the midst of the rite. Most of his party has been successfully evacuated, but five remain unaccounted for. That's not good. Please find them and see them out of harm's way. Aye, aye, Captain. And now there will suddenly be people. I believe. I don't see any people. Oh, here we are. I am helping you. Get out of here, nerd. Got another person to save. You alright? Gottfried sent you? I'm no longer of use here. Pray help the hearer in my stead. You. What the? Hey. Okay. I'm not one to question the universe. Brood? Oh god. Alright, and that was the last one I needed for my journal. So I'm already almost level 10. That's pretty nice. You were sent to help? I fear you are too late. The ritual has failed. I must return to Gridania. The Seed Seers must know of this. Oh great, more imps. Because that's what I want to deal with right now. Ugh. Well, that's that cleaned up. You okay, dude? Get up. That thing was no elemental, but a being born of darkness. The hero languishes alone in the depths. You must help him. I wasn't part of the fate, so I really don't care. Rude. Alright, so this is time for our second instance. Instances are fun. They totally don't involve giant trees beating our shit in.
Mournful voice of creation, grant ye this humble stoner soul that it may wake to life.
What? Oh god! That's not a shadow. That is literally rocks. How the hell am I supposed to kill this with arrows exactly? Oh my god! I'll shoot it dead! Just make it go away! Oh my god, this thing... How am I killing it? I mean, I'm not complaining, it's just weird. Okay, so... I guess now I get to practice my... Oh god, my rotation. I'm not very accurate for an archer, am I? I don't know, sir. I just got here. Maybe you should stop putting bright AoE triangles on the ground so I can see where it's going to be. That would be very important. See, these bright AoE triangles, they don't help you. They make it easier for me to dodge. Oh god. Okay, back to work. No, you stay poisoned, sir. I did not give you my permission to not be the poisoned. Oh god. Get miseried. I'm sorry, you think I'm golem? Oh my god.
That the golem could be vanquished. That man is no ordinary adventurer.
Damnation! He has eluded us yet again! Oh, fancy meeting you here. How are things? Oh, I just shot a rock golem to death. Oh my god! You all right? Your eyes glazed over there for a while. Yeah, I'm fine. Good news is, the hero is unharmed. Somewhat dazed, yes, but whole of mind and body. The bad news concerns everything else. Lest you forget, the 12th wood is the domain of the elementals. It is by their leave that man abides in the forest and avails himself of its bounty. The ground which the dungeon occupies is no different. Having no more use of the dungeon, the Grindanians sent a hero to offer the place back to the elementals by way of the right of returning, which is essentially an expression of gratitude. Alas, he failed to complete the ritual for obvious reasons. While the poor soul cannot be blamed for this, the fact that remains that unless the elementals are given their due, they may well consider it a slight. And the very last thing the Gridanians can afford to do in these uncertain times is risk alienating the Twelveswood's eternal guardians. But you have done more than your part. We shall see the hero to safety and send for his fears to finish the rite. In the meantime, please make your way outside and report to Elistan. Ah, but where are my manners? I am Papalimo, and the tactless woman beside me here is Ida. Papalimo and I are surveying the Twelveswood together. Pleased to meet you. Ida, give me a hand, would you? Wait, there's something familiar about it. Could it be that you are... Never mind. Doubtless my eyes are playing tricks. Till we meet again. We did it. We did it. And now we can leave. Screw you, imps. Want nothing to do with your kind. I said ignore me, you bastards. You sure, persistent little shit. Fine, I'll kill you, but only because you really want me to. All this happened inside Spared Hold 12. Preserve us. Who is that masked man? And by what dark ambition is he driven? So many things shrouded in mystery. Well, I shan't find any answers on my own. I must discuss this with Galfried. The matter warrants a full investigation. If I am any judge, that shall certainly be my recommendation. Your courage has saved many lives this day, adventurer. For this, you have my deepest gratitude. Pray seek me own. I understand she wishes to thank you for your efforts on our behalf. And now I finally have an excuse to use return. Hail ye. Hey, Mion, I did all that adventuring. Welcome back, Zig. A little bird tells me that the hero and his party owe you their lives. A tale for the tavern, if ever there were one. It is only a shame that I must ask you not to tell it, for the time being, at least. Do I make myself clear? Until the hearers have made their will on the matter known, it would be best to avoid unsettling people with stories of walking statues. Now then, you must have suitable recompense for your valiant service. For the first half of your reward, I give you leave to make use of the accommodations here at the guild. Arrangements have been made, so all you need to do is speak with Antoine whenever you crave the comfort of a firm bed and a soft pillow. For the second half of your reward, I shall offer you another path of fame and fortune, guild levies. Guild levies are records of the various requests we receive from the citizenry. They outline all manner of tasks which ambitious young adventurers like you can elect to undertake. Gontran is a guild levy official, or levy mate, here at the Carline Canopy. I have spoken with him regarding your knack for solving challenging problems, and he is eager to make your acquaintance. By the way, have you perchance heard about the coming festival? It is truly a splendid occasion, looked forward by young and old alike, and I heartily recommend that you take the time to enjoy. Don't be too disappointed if the recent troubles cast a shadow over the proceedings. However, I fear nothing short of the mysterious interloper's apprehension can prevent that. But we were talking about you, Zayek. You have made Mother proud. I expect great things of you, young man. I feel creeped out now, but I will happily take my new helmet. God, I look silly. You now have access to recommendations. This feature displays a list of quests or duties currently available in your area. The recommendations list can be opened from under duty in the main menu, and will also be displayed automatically when you log in. If you yourself are unsure of what to do next, this tool makes it simple to locate activities suitable for your present class and level. Whew. Da da da. We're even better at things now. And I'm not done yet. On to Bent Branch. Impressed by your progress, Mion wishes to send you to Bent Branch Meadows, where you will find further opportunities to learn. How's my favorite fresh-faced adventurer? Oh, do not scowl, so. I speak out of habit. You've come a long way since you first walked through my door, and I'll not deny it. As a matter of fact, I think it's about time you made yourself useful at Bent Branch Meadows in the Central Shroud. Unlike the recruits you see at the Bannock, the men and women out there are fully occupied with their own work. As such, I imagine there are more than a few who would welcome the assistance of a rapidly maturing adventurer like yourself. Bent Branch is also home to a very useful situated aetherite. It is, in other words, the perfect place for you to begin the next stage of your journey as an adventurer. And what better time than the present? Leave the city via the Blue Badger Gate and continue southwest until you come to a bridge. Cross it, and when you spy an aetherite in the distance, you may congratulate yourself on having successfully found Bent Branch Meadows. BD, stop dancing over there! If you so fancy, you may also make use of the Chocobo Porter service. Doubtless the safest way to your destination, Chocobo Keeper Singer should not hesitate to lend his birds to a capable adventurer like you. Oh, and be sure to introduce yourself to Keitha, the head Chocobo Wrangler, when you arrive. Sure. I'm game. I like Chocobos. So can I actually take the Chocobo port? I recall that you have to actually unlock... What the hell happened here? Whatever, I'm gonna leave before I get more confused. Hello! I'm Chocobo Porter. Well met, traveler. May I interest you in a porter? Ah, do not tell me. This is your first visit to this stop. I shall update my register with your name so that you may access this location in the future. Chocobo porters are those who will basically give you a ride anywhere so long as you're willing to pay the gil. You just sit there, the game takes control, and rides you safely to your destination. You can't be stopped by mobs, and, well, honestly, the music's just good. Oh my god. Yeah, don't spam me with ads. I will end your life. Found the aetherite. It's easy. Don't worry about it. And now we're bucked off right here. And we have a new Chocobo keep to register ourselves at. Except we're already registered to it because this game is very, very, very prepared for itself. Now, just one thing I'd recommend you do before you progress the main plot. Sync up with this thing. You're going to be doing a lot of quests in this area. And if you're prone to death like me in the early game, one of the first things you're going to want to do... register this as your favorite destination. Now, enough of that. Time for final main plot stuff. And then I think we'll call the episode there. Hello, miss. You must be the venturer Mion sent word about. I am Keitha, head wrangler around these parts. I've heard many and more things about you. Good things, lest you worry. When the Elder Seedseer bade us welcome venturers, 'tis fair to say we had our doubts. To hard-working folk like yourself set about proving us wrong, that is. Consider me a convert. Any road, you've a mind to help out at the ranch, have you? Good. We could always do with a hand or two to keep the place running smoothly. As a matter of fact, I've got a task right here that wants doing. Let me know when you're ready to get to business. Oh, and you come highly recommended, so don't go letting no one down, eh? Wasn't in my plans? Oops, I did not mean to do that at all. I would like the fancy red pants, because they're fancy. Now, if I'm right... Oh, I didn't hit the quest wall. That's unexpected. But I'm afraid that this episode's gone on for more than long enough. I'm gonna put on my new pants, and then we're gonna call it an episode. Yeah. Still no shoes, though. That's a little weird. But beggars can't be choosers. Yeah, I put on my longbow. Okay. Well, that's the end of this episode. In the next episode, we will hopefully finish Tutorial Island. Well, it's not actually Tutorial Island, but you know what I mean. We'll finish off the tutorial stuff and move on with our lives. So, until next time, this is Zach 400, signing off. Later, guys!